Hi, my name is Ashwada. I'm 9 years old and I stay in New York. And today I'm going to talk about electricity. Electricity is a flow of tiny particles called electrons and protons. Electrons have a negative charge and protons have a positive charge. Now let's go on with forms of electricity. There are two major forms of electricity. There are static electricity and current electricity. Static electricity is generated while rubbing two or more objects together. Current electricity is the electricity used in our homes. Now let's go with sources of electricity. The sources of electricity are fossil fuels, nuclear, water energy, solar energy, and wind energy. When fossil fuels are burned, the molecules of carbon and hydrogen react, causing it to create a large amount of energy. Nuclear energy is used during nuclear fission. It is used to heat up water to about 520 degrees Fahrenheit. This hot water is used to spin turbines which spin generators which produce electricity. And now let's go on with water energy. Water energy is the energy from water. Water was used to spin wheels, which spins turbines, which spins generators that produce electricity. This is known as hydropower. Hydropower stations are built near dams and waterfalls, which uses the flowing water to spin the turbines. Now let's go on to solar electricity. Solar electricity is the energy we get from the sun. Solar panels convert the sun's heat into electricity. We can say the light is the flow of protons. In a solar panel, there will be three layers. The top layer has electrons, which has a negative charge. The bottom layer has protons, which have a positive charge. And in the solar panel, there is a material called a semiconductor. The semiconductor is called silicon. A semiconductor is an object which conducts electricity only in a particular condition. So, when the light hits the middle layer of the solar panel, it will knock out an electron from it. The electron will go to the top and the protons go to the bottom. This process repeats as much times as possible. Then there will be wires connected to the top layer and bottom layer which take the electrons and protons to a converter. It is taken to a converter because the current which comes from solar panels is direct current. So the converter converts the direct current into alternate current. So then it will be used so that it can be used in a daily home uses and business. And now let's go on with wind energy. Wind energy is the energy from the wind. When windmills convert the wind's kinetic energy into electrical energy. In a windmill, there will be a turbine. The turbine catches the breeze and spins it. It will be connected to a generator which produces electricity. But you cannot directly connect it to a generator, because the rotation of the turbine will be very slow, which is not enough speed for the generator to produce electricity. So it will be connected to a gearbox before connecting to the generator, which will spin till increase the rotation of the turbine by a factor of 100. Then it will be connected to the generator, which will produce power. And the current produced is also direct current. So it will be connected to a converter which converts the direct current into alternate current. So then it will be connected to our homes and we will use it every day. And this is the model I have made. You can see it has a blade and it will be connected to a motor. So when the wind power is given, the turbine will spin and will spin the generator, and the generator will produce electricity. And when there is no wind, it cannot work. So So when there's less wind, it will rotate slower. And this is how wind energy is converted into electrical energy. The solar energy, wind energy and water energy are renewable energy because if we keep on using it, it will not run out. Fossil fuels and nuclear energy, if we keep on using, one day it will run out. Thank you and bye-bye.